मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। ओके, बिफोर कंटिन्यूइंग फर्दर आई जस्ट वांट टू आस्क फ्यू क्वेश्चंस टू जस्ट गेट गिव अ बेटर क्लैरिटी। बेसिकली व्हेन यू वी आर सॉल्विंग ओनली लीनियर एक्सप्रेशंस, हाउ टू सॉल्व क्वाड्रेटिक वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी लेटर। इज माय वॉइस क्लियर टू एवरीवन?
यस
यस सर।
ओके, so we are going to study about how to solve quadratic expressions or cubic expression with inequalities. We'll study later. Okay, we are only studying linear inequalities, but sometimes we'll find a linear expression into a quadratic expression. Maybe it is a perfect square or perfect square plus a constant where it is always positive or it is greater than or equal to zero. If it is always positive, we don't have any issue, we'll just divide or multiply with it. But whenever it becomes zero, it is positive or zero but not negative, when it is zero, that part has to be taken care. Okay, so I want to give a better clarity on that. At this term may be clear, but just again we want to just remember one thing. You think of, okay, right side we'll see later, look at all these four questions and try to think of what is the answer for each one of them. I'll ask some people, but think about all these four, left side four, what will be the answers. You don't have to write in all different ways, just write in inequality form of solution or closed interval or open interval. Normally our physics class will close by 1 o'clock or it will be extended?
Yes, sir.
Usually they stop at 1 o'clock.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. Today afternoon I want to take an additional class at 1:50, everybody. 1:50 to 2:50. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'll send the ID later, but class is there for everybody. 152. We will continue inequality.
Sir, 1:50, sir.
Yeah, 1:50 PM, 10 to 2. Okay, 10 minutes before. But I have a class at 3 o'clock. That's why I have to give. All right. Can anybody say what is the difference between answer for this and answer for this? Anybody? Between first and second. You don't have to ask may I and all. Okay, this is open interval 5 to infinity for this answer, right? Whereas for this answer is open interval 5 to infinity minus
7, sir.
It excludes 7. Okay, you can also write that as 5, 7 union 7, infinity. Okay, what about this one?
x not equal to 7 and x not equal to 5.
Accept that anything else is okay. Number 2 is okay. Number 100 okay. Minus 10 also okay.
x less than 5.
Same as the previous one, x greater than 5, and again x should not be 7 because when x is, yeah, x should not be 5 because it will be 0, but anyway we are writing open 5. X should not be 7 because this is basically, this is always positive, you can send that side, nothing wrong, but it should not be 0, that's why we removed 7. Similarly, this is always positive, I can send that side, but when it is 0, I don't have equal to 0, I have only greater than 0. So here also same answer, 5, infinity minus 7. Here also you can write 5, 7 union 7, infinity. What about this one?
Five to infinity.
Sir, x okay. not equal to 1 and x greater than
5 to infinity excluding.
5 to infinity excluding 1. Should I have to mention excluding 1 or is it not required?
Not required.
In your answer, if 1 comes, you have to exclude it. It is not there. Okay? This is always positive. At 1, it is 0. So 1, I have to exclude. But after sending this side, I got x greater than 5. When I tell greater than 5, that 1 is not there. So I have to write again. So it is simply 5 comma infinity. I don't have to write subtract 1. Okay? What about this one?
Same, sir.
Same. Okay. Here also, it is always positive. I can send that side. But 1 should be excluded because there is no equality here. But I am getting answer 5 to infinity. It doesn't contain 1. So here also 5 comma infinity. Okay. Anybody any doubt in any one of these four answers?
No, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Saket, are you clear about all these things?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, coming to this. Okay. I want more girls also should answer. Okay. So, this for these answers only girls should tell. Anybody, no problem. Okay. What is the answer for first one? What is the answer for second one?
First one, x is greater than or equal to 5.
Okay, x greater than or equal to 5. So closed 5 to infinity. Okay. What about second one?
The same, but x7 should be
excluded.
Okay, so closed 5 to infinity minus 7, or you can write closed 5 to open 7, union 7 to infinity. All right. Okay, what about this one?
The same, sir.
Same, sir. 7 should be excluded.
Are you sure 7 should be excluded?
No, sir. No, sir. It can also be 0.
If you put 7, it is equal to 0. Nothing wrong, right? Okay, so let the 7 be there. Okay. So it is closed 5 to infinity only. Don't have to remove 7. Because why are you removing earlier 7? Because it becomes 0 and we don't want it because it is only greater than 0. But now what is the problem? Equal to 0 is there, right? Yeah, so it is closed 5 to infinity including 7. Alright? Okay. What about this one?
Closed 5 to infinity.
Okay. Here we have to here we excluded 7. Here we have to exclude 1. But in the answer, 1 is not there. So, why to exclude it? So, it is only closed 5 to infinity. I don't want 1. Anyway, did not come in the answer. Okay, that's fine. Okay, what about this one?
Closed 5 to infinity.
This last one, Harish, once again, think about the answer.
Yes, sir. Closed 5 to
infinity.
Okay. Anybody, boys or girls, anybody, no problem. You want to tell any other answer for this?
Sir, including 1. 1 is also a solution, right?
Yes. 1 alone is also a solution. Why? When x is other than 1, it is positive. I can send that side. I'll get x greater than 5. But when x is 1, it's not that I should exclude. I should include it. And it's not there in the answer. Because when x is 1, it is 0. 0 into positive or negative doesn't matter. It will be 0. So how to write that answer? A is separately 1 union closed 5 to infinity. Okay. That is the answer. Yes, Naveen, what is your doubt, Naveen?
Sir, cleared, sir. I was really confused.
Okay, all right. So all these questions look same. Sometimes we are including 7, sometimes we are excluding 7. Okay. So, when there is equality, you have to be a little careful. When there is no equality, not an issue. Why? If it is in the denominator, anyway, it should not be 0. Whenever it is 0, we'll exclude it. The positive part, the perfect square or perfect power, even power. When it is in the numerator also, again, it should not be 0. So, we have to exclude this. Okay. So, when our power is odd, we'll discuss later. We are only talking about power is even. When our power is even, it is either 0 or positive. If it is 0, either in the denominator or numerator, we don't want it. For strictly greater than 0 or strictly less than 0. So we'll exclude that. Here also we have to exclude 1, but it's not even there in the part of the answer. So we don't have need to exclude. Okay, even though these two are more or less same, here 7 came as a part of the answer, so we have to exclude it. Here 1 also we don't want it, but it is anyway not there in the final inequality, so nothing to bother. But when equality is there, we have to be, if it is in the denominator, anyway we have to exclude it, it should not be 0. If it is in the numerator, when it is 0, it is quite acceptable. Okay, even though where is that this question and this question are more or less same, but answer appears to be different. Why? Because here already 7 is there in the part of the other inequality. So we don't have to separately think. But 1 is also answer, but it did not come in the other part. So we have to separately write as a unit. I think this covers all the models, that is multiplying a linear expression with a perfect square or a perfect power 4 or perfect power 8. You can multiply that in the numerator or denominator, whether it is equality or not equality. Okay. And that answer, when it is 0, that may be included in the answer, it may be excluded. That means it may be already there or not there. I covered all the possible cases that can come up with a linear expression multiplied or divided with a perfect square or any other even form. Anybody, any doubt in any part of this?
Sir?
Yes, Meghavani.
Now, where do we use that? We'll first draw a number line and we'll draw curves on it and we'll give some alternative plus minus something.
Yeah. We'll come to that. Okay. That is called a wavy curve method. We are going to come after 2-3 exercises. But when you do all these things properly, there will not be any mistakes. Otherwise, there will be a little confusion. Right. Okay. Everybody done with this, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are going to. Saket, is that clear to you now?
Yes, sir. It is okay, clear.
Mainly for you, I discussed. Last class, said you are not clear. That's why I gave all these examples.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so last class, section, what is it we have done? Anybody remember? Section 3, did we complete or no?
Completed,
sir.
13 also completed. Okay, fine. Okay, section 4, odd numbers I'm going to do. And then exercise 2, I have to give some introduction about it. Okay. So section 4 is there on the screen. You can try first and third. Just try this too. Okay, tomorrow I'm going to clarify if at all anybody has any doubts in all these sections, exercise 1 total. After that, tomorrow evening, everybody has to submit the homework. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, all good. So this question is, I have to read carefully. find the set of all reverse vectors for which the inequality holds for all x greater than equal to 4. Nine x square plus 12x plus 4 minus 4x square minus 4x minus 4. Minus 5x square plus k is greater than equal to 3. X square is getting cancelled. 12x minus 4x is 8x. 4 minus 1 is 3. Plus k is greater than equal to 3. It is not about solving the inequality. We have to consider x is more than 5. I want to send both 8x plus to that side. K is greater than or equal to minus of 8x plus 3. Okay, so k should be greater than all these numbers. Okay, if x belongs to 5, then 8x plus 3 belongs to closed interval 43 to infinity. Minus of 8x plus 3 belongs to minus infinity to minus 43. And k should be greater than all these numbers. So k should be greater than or equal to every real number in minus infinity to minus 43. So k should be greater than or equal to minus 40. Plus 4 minus 1 plus 3, correct? 12x minus 4x, 8x, correct? Yes. Okay, so this question is not that we'll try to find x greater than or equal to what? That is not our question exactly. Okay. The question is, when x is more than 5, this should be positive. Whatever x you take after 5. But whatever x you take after 5, this value is between minus infinity to minus 43. And this k should be more than all these numbers. If k is more than the greatest number, then it will be greater than all these numbers. So k greater than equal to, find a set of all real values. So all real values is minus 43 to infinity. Is it okay for first one?
Yes, sir.
So all possible values of k are closed interval minus.
Can you explain again?
Yeah. The question is, whatever x you take after 5, this expression should be positive. When you take before 5, it may be negative, I don't care. Okay? This should be greater than or equal to 0. So I send 8x plus 3 that side. Because look at this is the main part of the statement. Whenever x not belongs to 5, sorry. Whenever x is greater than or equal to 5. If x is greater than or equal to 5, 8x plus 3. What is the minimum value of 8x plus 3 when you put 5? 43. Anything more than 5 you take, it will be more than 43. So for all these values of x which are beyond 5, the 8x plus 3 values are beyond 43. And minus of 8x plus 3 values are negative of this, which is from minus infinity to minus 43. So whatever x you take at 5 or more than that, all these values are this. And this k should be greater than all those values. K should be greater than minus infinity, minus 100, minus 1000, minus 50 minus 43. If k is greater than the greatest number among these, it is obviously greater than the rest of the numbers. Among all the numbers in this, what is the greatest number? Minus 43. So k should be greater than every real number in this interval means k should be greater than the greatest number, which is minus 43. So k can be minus 43 or anything higher than. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
sir. Why can't we do like that? Why can't we find the equation for x is greater than something and put that put 5 in that equation?
X should be greater than or equal to something. That should be. You can do that, but you have to understand what is that we are doing. That is the main thing. Okay, I can write what is there. X greater than or equal to minus of 8 plus k by 3, and x should be greater than or equal to 5. Okay, but how are you going to combine these two? Okay, so you want this to be true for all x greater than 5, right?
Yes.
Then you have to understand this number should be less than 5. Okay. Or it should be more than 5. It should be more than 5. Why? Let us say if x is greater than or equal to 7, it is true for all x greater than or equal to 5 now. So this number can be 5 or 6 or 7 or 8. So you have to carefully understand that this should be greater than or equal to 5. Minus of 8 plus k by 3 should be greater than or equal to 5. Is it correct or wrong? Then I'll be getting k less than or equal to direct in a correct overall form. K plus 3 by 8, sorry. Okay, so the given statement is true for this range, but we want it to be true for every number between 5 to infinity. So if this is less than 5, okay, then the given statement is true for any number which is less than 5 to infinity. What to speak of as subset of that? Yeah. You have to here carefully understand this can be anything less than 5. But understanding that, somebody can be a little confused there. So I thought this way people will understand better. That's why. But you can do like this, but carefully you have to understand this should be less than equal to 5. And this is 3 plus k by 8 should be greater than equal to minus 5. Then you will get k greater than equal to minus 43. But we should understand why I took this less than this or this greater than this. There should be proper reason now. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Understood.
Okay. So anybody has any confusion, any doubt, please feel free to ask.
Sir, can you once again explain from the step if x greater than equal to 3?
The other method I told, that one or is this one?
This one, sir, this one.
What is there on the board? Okay, fine. See, I want a k, number k should be greater than this number, this expression. But not for all values of x. I want only for x greater than or equal to 5. So when x is 5 or more than that, let us see what are these values giving. When x is 5, what is the answer for this part?
43, sir.
Minus 43. Okay. What about when x is 6, 7, 8, 9, 100, 1000 when I take, what will come to these values? When I take 100, it will be some minus 797. Or sorry, minus 803. When I take 1000, it will be minus 8003. So when I take any number more than 5, its values are coming from minus 43 backward up to minus infinity. Am I right? And k should be greater than all those numbers. K should be, when x is 5, k should be greater than that. When x is 10, k should be greater than that. When x is 20 also, k should be greater than that. So whatever x you take beyond 5, k should be greater than that. But whatever x you take beyond 5, these values are coming from minus infinity to minus 43. K should be bigger than all those values. If you want k to be greater than minus infinity, minus 100, minus 1000, minus 43, if k is the greater than the greatest among these, it is automatically greater than rest of them. And among these numbers, okay, what is the greatest number? Minus 43, and k should be greater than that. Is it okay?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to erase this whole thing. Okay, coming to third question. 4 minus 3x whole square is a perfect square, so we have to only vary when it is 0, when it is positive and all. Coming to the other one, power 5 is not so important, but we'll write it anyway. 2x minus 1 minus 4x plus 3 power 5 less than 0. Okay, so double implies it is always positive. Only thing is that it should not be 0. So 4 minus 3x whole square should not be 0. And now except this is always positive, so I can send that side and write this is minus 2x plus 2 whole power 5 is less than 0 by 4 minus 3x whole square. Because it is positive, I divide it and 0 by something is 0 anyway. Which implies x should not be 4 by 3. And power 5 is not important. Okay, if it is negative, power 5 is also negative. So I have to remove minus 2x plus 2 should be less than 0. Which double implies x should not be 4 by 3. And 2 less than 2x. Plus x should not be 4 by 3. And x is greater than 1. Okay. So whenever you take a linear expression power, any odd power you can remove that. It doesn't affect the answer because if that is positive, power 5 is positive. If that is negative, power 5 is negative. It doesn't change inequality. And whenever something is even power, you have to see if where it is 0. That should be avoided when there is no equal. And 4 by 3 is the part of it. So you can write here what is that the solution set equal to. Closed 1 to infinity, sorry, open 1 to infinity, except 4 by 3. Or 1 to 4 by 3 union, 4 by 3 to infinity. Or x such that x is greater than 1 and x not equal to 4 by 3. If you're on number line, open 1 and open 4 by 3. Everything in between. Okay, everything after 1 except 1 and 4. Vidyalakshmi, how your brother has given advanced exam, how he has given?
Okay, sir. Good, sir.
Okay. Anyway, you said he's a cool boy, doesn't feel so much tension. So most probably might have done well.
Sir, they have asked us smallest positive integer satisfying it.
Oh, okay, okay. Not just solution set, smallest positive. So greater than 1 and except 4 by 3. What is the smallest integer? 2, huh?
2.
2, sir.
Okay. So then I don't need number line and all that. Smallest positive. This boy Narasimha Naidu also not fully satisfied with his performance yesterday exam. Okay. Don't know. Below 10 getting chances may be less. Don't know. Anything can happen, but 1 to 100 you can get something. But below 10, or you don't know. In the future, you have to be writing 6 hours exam. Okay. Nowadays, we are only keeping only mains or only advanced. But the future will be keeping morning 3 hours exam mains and afternoon 3 hours advanced exam.
Sir?
Yes, please.
That exam will happen in college, sir, when there will be real classes.
Physical classes? No, actual exam you have to go to outside some other college where they give center, you have to write there. Okay. Some engineering college or some computer lab. Something. Mains also like that. Sir. There are some private places are there. Okay, so everybody clear about this third one, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So next I have to discuss about absolute inequalities and all that. Okay, I'm going to erase whatever is there on the board. All right. Okay, so absolute value function. Okay, after that we are going to say absolute inequalities. Okay, absolute value of x. Is equal to mod x, generally we represent. The definition is this: it is equal to x if x is greater than 0, it is equal to 0 if x is equal to 0, it is equal to minus x if x is less than 0. And this equal to 0, you can combine here or here, doesn't matter. If somebody wants to write x if x is greater than or equal to 0, minus x if x is less than 0, nothing wrong. If somebody want to write x if x is greater than 0, minus x if x is less than or equal to 0. All three are same. Okay. So, because at 0, whether you call plus x or minus x, doesn't matter. You can define any way you want. All are same. Generally, we talk about this or this, but nothing wrong in other. But I also mentioned one more thing. Okay. It is distance between 0 and x on number line. Distance between 0 and x on number line. Because distance cannot be negative. Okay. And almost similar, I want to write mod x1 minus x2. Okay. Somebody can define as x1 minus x2 if x1 minus x2 is greater than 0, or I can even write equal to, or x1 greater than or equal to x2, both are same. And you can write minus of x1 minus x2. When it is positive, let as it is. When it is negative, let minus. If x1 minus x2 is less than 0, or x1 less than x2. This also can be written as distance between x1 and x2 on the number line. Distance between x1 and x2 on number line. Okay, all of you know, whatever x is positive or negative, mod x will finally give a positive answer. If it is 0, it is 0. All of you know that. Nothing new. Okay, mod x answer will never be negative. But doesn't mean mod x equal to x. When x is actually negative, okay, we have to write minus x. Just for example, mod 7, it is 7. Mod 0, it is 0. Sorry, 7. Mod 0 is 0. mod minus 3, we know answer is plus 3, and the 3 can be written as minus or minus. So here I took x as 7, answer also came x. Here I took x as 0, answer also came x. When I took x as minus 3, answer is not x, it is actually minus of x. Okay. So one should not think mod x equal to x without knowing whether it is positive or negative. These are just some example of it. Okay, everybody clear about mod x definition, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, please write all these things.
Sir, if x is less than or equal to 0, 0 is also there, no, sir. How it will become minus x?
I do not get your doubt, Saket.
Sir, in third one you wrote now, minus x, if x is less than, here, right side.
Yeah, correct.
Yes, sir.
Minus 0 is also 0, no?
Yes, sir.
Minus, okay. So, the 0 okay. Part, whether you want to include here or include here, doesn't matter. That's what I'm saying. Less 0, minus 0, both are 0.
Okay.
Sir?
Yes.
Left side you wrote mod x values, no, this side only, sir, x if x greater than 0.
Okay,
left side you wrote mod x values and right side you wrote value of x if it is greater or lesser or equal to 0, sir.
Correct, this one mod x, it can be x, it can be minus x. When it is x, when x is positive. When it is minus x, when x is negative.
Okay, sir.
All of them say only one thing. Whenever it is positive, write as it is. Whenever it is negative, write negative of that. When it is zero, no problem. Okay. Okay, now so this whole thing what I gave, I want to call it as first point, the defining mod x. Okay, second point is related to this. If mod x is equal to k, okay, what is the possible x values will be? Anybody?
Plus k and minus k.
Are you sure?
Or zero.
Zero also,
how? Okay, it depends on. Okay, I'll give you three questions. Mod x equal to 3, mod x equal to 0, mod x equal to minus 5. Tell me, what are the solutions for this?
Less or minus 3.
Plus minus 3.
For this?
0.
0.
For this?
Minus 5. No. Not possible.
Not possible.
Mod of something cannot be negative, right? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I just gave mod x equal to k. I did not tell you k is positive or negative. You should have asked me whether k is positive or negative. Yeah, plus or minus k is correct if k is positive. If k is negative, no solution. Okay. So mod x equal to k, I'll have three possibilities. It implies x is equal to plus or minus k if k is greater than 0. Implies x equal to 0 if k equal to 0. And no such x if k is negative. If k is less than. Because mod x answer cannot be negative, it is always positive. So it's a negative, no solution. Is it okay, everybody?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Mod x minus a equal to b and b greater than 0. That's 0. So I can respect all the possibilities. There. Okay, b greater than 0, what will happen? B equal to 0, what will happen? And b less than 0, what?
Sir, x is equal to a plus or minus b.
Yeah, no solution here. Here x minus a should be 0 implies x is equal to a. Here x minus a equal to plus or minus b. So x is equal to a plus or minus b. Okay, this is fairly simple because mod of something is b means that the inner part can be plus b or minus b. Of course, b should be positive. That is very easy. I want to see them sometimes as distance also. Basically, what if this cell says from origin, I want a number, we should be at a distance of k units because mod x means distance between x and number 0. From number 0 at a distance of k units, you can go this side, you can go this side. If you go this side, plus k. If you go this side, then minus k. Here, what if this distance between x and a? A is here. From A, I have to go B units forward. If this gap is B, what is that number? A plus B. If I go B units backward, what is this number? A minus B. Can you all of you understand the distance way of explanation?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
What is mod x means? Distance between x and 0, no? I want a number, let's say mod x equal to 7. Distance between x and 0 is 7 units. That means from 0, you can go 7 units forward, find that number, or you can go 7 units backward and find that number. What are the numbers?
Plus 7 and minus, or minus.
Let's say I give mod x minus 10 equal to 3. Distance between x and number 10 should be 3. So on the number line, take 10. From that, you can go 3 units forward or 3 units backward. What are the numbers?
13 and 7, sir.
10 plus 3 or 10 minus 3, right?
Yes, sir.
That is exactly this. A plus B or A minus B. That's it.
Sir, then what is that x minus A is equal to plus or minus B, sir?
Mod of something is B means obviously what is that I wrote.
Yes, sir. If mod is sent to other side, it is plus or minus.
Not mod is sent to that side. If mod of something is K, that inner part should be either plus k or minus k. Like that, if mod of something is b, that inner part can be plus b or minus.
Okay, sir.
Okay, am I raising this whole thing? Okay, fourth point. If somebody gives me mod x less than k, mod x less than k, again I'll have three cases. Okay. Here I want to take k greater than 0, k equal to 0, and k less than 0. Okay, I can write my inequalities properly and all that, but if I say mod x less than 5, tell me in some number satisfying this.
Less or minus 5. Sorry.
So minus 4.
Less okay, minus 4, minus 4, 3, minus 3, 2, minus 2, 0, 1. Okay. If minus I say positive 4, numbers, 2, plus 4, 0 to 5, anything is okay. If I take negative numbers, minus 5 to 0, anything is okay. Am I right?
Yes.
I cannot go beyond 5. I cannot go less than minus 5, and 5 is not included in it. Another way of saying same thing is, what is the mod x is after all? Distance between 0 and x. And that distance could not cross 5. So I go 5 units forward, I go 5 units backward. I cannot go beyond this, and I cannot go beyond this. So only this, what is that? Everything between minus 5 to 5. So mod x less than k means x is between minus k to k, provided it is a positive number. If somebody asks you mod x less than minus 2, don't say x is between minus 2 to 2. Mod of x is positive. Positive number cannot be less than negative number.
Negative.
Yeah, so there will not be any solution. Okay. So when k is negative, no solution. and k is 0 also no solution, because mod x is positive. Even if you take 0, 0 cannot be less than 0. Okay, so no solution. Mod x less than 0 also doesn't have any solution. Mod x is less than k, where k is a positive number, then x should be between minus k to k. Minus k less than x less than k. You should be able to write this directly. Not that you will remove mod and write sometimes plus x less than k, sometimes minus x less than k. You can write nothing wrong. What is minus x less than k means x is greater than minus k. So x is more than minus k, and less than k means minus k less than x less than k. Same thing only. You can write minus k less than x. Because mod x, when x is positive, it is x. When x is negative, it is minus x. The multiple is minus inequality change, then I reversed it. I got minus k less than x less than k. X should be between minus k to k. But without all that simple common sense, mod x less than 7 means x can be 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, all the way up to minus 7. Or on the number line from 0, I can go 7 units forward, plus 7. I can go 7 units backward, minus 7. I cannot cross that distance. I can run anything less than that. All these things is between minus 7 to 7. So this is the main part you should know. Mod x less than k means directly x should be between minus k to k. We are going to do a lot of questions based on this. Is everybody clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Out of all the things, this is very, very important. We are going to use. Okay. Okay. If somebody gives mod x less than or equal to k, equality is also there. Again, if this is k greater than 0, k equal to 0, k less than 0. Again, k less than 0, obviously no solution. Here, k equal to 0 can be solution. Mod x less than or equal to 0. Can mod x, whatever x you take, can it be less than or equal to 0?
When x equal to 0 can be equal to
0. When x equal to 0 is fine. Equal to 0 is possible. Any other number, it is positive, not less than, greater than. So only solution is x equal to 0. But if it is positive, same like the previous one, but equality. Minus k less than or equal to x, less than equal to x. Only difference between here and here, equality is there. Okay, mod x greater than k. Okay, k is greater than 0 and k is equal to 0 and k less than 0. Okay. Okay, Snigdha. Mod x greater than minus 7. Can you tell me some examples of x value satisfying this? One or two x values where mod x value is greater than minus 7. If I take x equal to 5, what is mod 5 value? You're not understood. I'm asking mod x greater than minus 7. Okay. Tell me some x values when I put it here. This inequality is correct.
Then nothing.
Anything greater than 0, positive values.
Let's say I'll take x equal to minus 3. If you put x equal to minus 3, will it be a correct statement or wrong statement?
Sir, all real numbers.
Sir, all negative and positive integers greater than 7.
Sir, any value?
Sir, all real numbers.
Sir, okay. Any value, sir.
Yeah. One should not worry about negative numbers here. Mod of minus 3 is 3. And 3 is greater than negative number. If I take minus 100, mod minus 100 is 100, which is also greater than minus 7. If I take 0, mod 0 is 0, that is also greater than minus 7. If I take minus 2, mod minus 2 is plus 2, and a positive number is greater than negative number. Sigda, is my voice audible to you?
Yes, sir, but it's breaking for me because my network is low.
Okay, fine. So, mod x greater than minus 7 is always true. X can be 0, x can be positive, x can be negative, doesn't matter. Mod x is always 0 or positive. When it is 0 is fine, when it is positive also fine. And mod x cannot be negative. All right?
Yes,
so,
sir.
For this, solutions are all real numbers. So when k is negative, x belongs to R. Okay. Solution set is R. All real numbers, which is minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. Anybody has any objection to this?
No, sir.
No objection. Okay. When k is 0, mod x greater than 0. When will mod x will be greater
sir,
than
0? Sir, x at 0, all the real numbers are.
Yeah, okay. Correct. Only at 0 it is 0. Any other x you take, it is positive only, and positive number is greater than 0. So here, solution set.
Sir.
All real numbers except 0. Which is minus infinity to 0, union 0 to infinity. You can also write minus infinity to infinity except 0. Anything else, all are fine. Yes, what is your doubt?
Sir, previously when you were representing set, you used curly brackets, no sir? Curly brackets, no sir? Here, why did you use?
What curly brackets for what?
Not curly, sir. Flower brackets you used previously, no sir, for representing set.
No. Only for writing few numbers. If I want to write 1 comma, 2 comma, 3, I used curly brackets. Otherwise, I was using open interval 5 to infinity, closed interval 2 to 3, I was using, na?
Okay, sir.
Right. So, only number 0 I want to remove, so I can use curly brackets or curly brackets, whatever you call it. Otherwise, here R is all real numbers. If you want to write open interval minus infinity, infinity like this. Okay, I hope everybody clear about these two things. Mod x greater than minus 5, that is the name. You can think about example for this. And mod x greater than 0 for this, right? Okay. Okay, now only k greater than 0, that part is there. I have to write that. Some place here. Okay, when k is greater than 0, let us for example, mod x is greater than 7. Okay, if you consider only positive numbers, what are the numbers will satisfy this? 8, 9, 10, 100, 1000, 7.2, 7.3, anything beyond 7. What negative yes. Numbers are okay for this?
Minus 7 to minus
7. So for this, what is okay is x less than minus 7 or x greater than 7. So like that x less than minus k or x should be more than k. Because if you take number line for this, from origin the distance to x should be beyond 7, more than 7 units. So it can cross 7 this side, or it has to cross minus 7 to the other side. So which is less than minus 7 or more than 7. Don't say x should be greater than minus 7. Some people write here less or minus x greater than 7. It's okay, nothing wrong, maybe, but you have to take positive separately, less than separately. After all, minus x greater than 7 means x less than minus 7 only when you multiply with negative number. Nothing wrong in that. So x should be more than 7 or not end. X should be more than 7 or x should be less than minus 7. In the same way for this, any number beyond k is okay. Or any number less than minus k is also okay. If you want, you can also write this as x belongs to minus infinity to minus k union k to infinity. You can also
sir,
write
this
as...
Sir, it should be open.
Oh yeah, open, thank you. You can also write that as x belongs to all real numbers minus closed interval minus k to k. Because we don't want closed interval minus k to k, everything except that. Okay, you can write like this, you can write like this, you can write like this. Please write all of them so you should know how to know, write in different ways. Here I get closed because I want to remove k. K should be there here, so that will be removed here. And here we don't want k, should be open. Okay, so I'll stop the class now. After finishing this, you can leave. But the one thing is, after the class, I may change the time. It's a little bit late. After 10 minutes, you see in the group, some message will be there. Definitely class is there. Whether 2:150 or 3:30 or something, I'll put a message. All right? Okay.
Okay. Yes. Thank you,
so
sir.
So total, exercise one, you complete. If any doubts, tomorrow I'll discuss doubts. Okay, all right. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.